When you look at the world's population density map, you might notice a trend. 40% of the world's population lives within 100 kilometers of a coast. Most of those people are living in and around large cities, and these dense urban areas are growing. That growth calls for more manufacturing, transportation, power plants, and electrical grids. Resources like this are often placed in cheaper, low-elevation land, which means that for many coastal communities, sea level rise caused by climate change isn't just a problem for the future. It's a problem right now. One of these places is the New Jersey Meadowlands. It's a 30-mile stretch of small towns built on marshlands. As the land here sinks and sea levels rise, some communities will begin to flood.
Once impacts become noticeable, such as water on low-lying streets, water coming over sea walls, once that becomes noticeable and problematic, it's going to become chronic rather quickly.
So how do we know that sea level is rising?
Oxygen isotopes.
The Gulf Stream, right?
In the bathymetry?
We have several sources of evidence.
Scientists like these guys use a variety of records to study sea level change.
The longest record where people have been observing sea level rise directly is with instruments called tide gauges.
These instruments measure the level of water as it goes up and down with the tide. Using these gauges, alongside geological records and satellites, scientists have recorded an acceleration in sea level, which they expect to continue through this century.
Between 2000 and 2050, we're probably looking at a range here in New Jersey of about 1 to 2 feet of sea level rise.
It's going to impact low-lying infrastructure in particular.
Imagine if you're on a train and you had to wait for high tide to go out before the train could go through, and what a disruption to the system that would be. And then multiply that by every other train line or roadway that goes at sea level.
The Meadowlands is 6 miles away from New York City's Times Square. It's one of the busiest transit corridors in the United States.
If you draw a line from Philadelphia to New York City or Philadelphia to Boston, you basically have to go through the Meadowlands. So as a result, all of the infrastructure that connects this region together bottlenecks down, comes together in the Meadowlands.
By year 2050, researchers estimate that 115 rail stations here would flood on a chronic basis. And by that time, nearly 60% of the region's current power generating capacity would be in a floodplain.
If you think back to Superstorm Sandy, and one of the iconic images of that storm was all of Lower Manhattan in darkness. It's not just an inconvenience in a home losing power. We could shut down the entire Northeast if we lost power.
Hurricane Sandy was and is a historic storm. Scientists recorded tides up to 20 feet higher than usual along the New Jersey and New York coastlines. It was the second costliest storm on record in the United States, and the tunnels that carry hundreds of thousands of commuters every day still need repair. But with a rising sea level, flooding will get worse during weather events that aren't nearly as extreme as Hurricane Sandy was.
The simple thing to understand is that with a higher sea level, it requires less of a storm to produce the same amount of flooding, and the same storm will produce more flooding.
And in other parts of New Jersey, there have been documented nuisance flooding events. Those can happen even when it doesn't rain.
Oftentimes the water will come from the ocean or rivers spilling its banks, not so much rainfall flooding.
On America's eastern coast, tides cycle 4 times a day, from high to low to high to low, but at certain points of the year, they can rise much higher than usual.
We're at a point now with continued sea level rise that those high tides of the year, oftentimes called king tides, with maybe a little extra wind behind them, they become a problem and actually start to flood communities.
According to NOAA, the annual number of high tide flood days is projected to increase fastest in New York City. And in a few decades, coastal cities on the Atlantic could experience high tide flooding as often as 3 times a week. Storm flooding like what Hurricane Sandy brought could become more persistent very soon. By the end of the century, many towns in New Jersey would find themselves underwater frequently, including this town in the heart of the Meadowlands. One report suggested it would lose all of its housing to chronic flooding. The response to sea level rise boils down to 3 options. Prevention is basically building higher seawalls, things like berms. Adaptation is elevation. Some critical infrastructure can't relocate for economic reasons, so it would just end up being cheaper to raise them. Retreat is basically returning the land to nature, but the state of New Jersey doesn't seem keen on that. In the last decade, a new NFL stadium was built, alongside large swaths of new housing, and there's an airport expansion plan. But all of that new concrete could increase flooding from stormwater runoff.
The Meadowlands is one of the biggest sponges in our region. If we get rid of those wetlands, or if we, you know, pave them over, we're going to be pushing water into other places. It's very hard to find any community that's looking at sea level rise as a threat that they're planning for today. Even if this is something that's 20 years away or so, the decisions we make today last into those 20 years and beyond, and we need to be doing more to prepare for those.
Sea level rise impacts are happening now. We're seeing them in the East Coast in terms of increased number of these sunny day flooding events. As sea levels continue to rise, impacts are going to become deeper, more severe, more widespread, and we're going to have to come to grips with the fact that the way that we live our lives today is not going to be the way that we live our lives in the future.
Yo, thank you for watching. If you liked that video, you're going to love what the Verge science team is making on their YouTube channel. You can check out one of their new videos right here. Again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.